Now we'll look at an example of finding the equation of a tangent line using the product rule. So given our function here, we want to find the equation of the tangent line at x equals negative 2. So before we find the derivative, in order to determine the slope of the tangent line at x equals negative 2, we need to recognize that in order to find the equation of a line, we actually have to find the point on the function. So they're giving us the x-coordinate, but we also have to find the y-coordinate in order to find the equation of the line. So we know our point, let's call it point P, has an x-coordinate of negative 2, but in order to find the y-coordinate, we need to find f of negative 2. So now we'll substitute negative 2 for x in our function. We're going to have negative 2, then we'll have plus, this will be 2 divided by negative 2, that'll be negative 1, times x squared, negative 2 squared is 4, 4 minus 3. So we have negative 3 times positive 1, so the y-coordinate of our point is negative 3. Now we can go ahead and find the derivative in order to find the slope of the tangent line when x equals negative 2. Now we could multiply this out, but we'll go ahead and apply the product rule. So we'll call this first function f and the second function g. So f prime of x is equal to the first function, which is x plus, I'm going to go ahead and write this as 2 times x to the negative 1. Remember, if we move this up into the numerator, it's going to change the sign of the exponent. So that's 2x to the negative 1 times the derivative of the second function, which will be the derivative of x squared minus 3. We'll come back and find that, plus the second function times the derivative of the first function, which again, I'm going to write this as x plus 2 times x to the negative 1. Now we'll find the derivative here and here, then multiply and simplify. So f prime of x is equal to x plus 2x to the negative 1 times the derivative of x squared minus 3 is just 2x, plus the quantity x squared minus 3 times the derivative of x plus 2x to the negative 1, that's going to be 1. And then for the derivative of 2x to the negative 1, we're going to multiply by negative 1, so it's going to be negative or minus 2x to the, subtract 1 from the exponent, that's going to be negative 2. Now let's go ahead and find these products and simplify our derivative function. We have 2x times x, that's 2x squared. And here we have 2x times 2x to the negative 1. Well, 2 times 2 is 4. X to the first times x to the negative 1 would be x to the 0, which is equal to 1. So this product is just 4, so we have plus 4. Here we're going to have 4 products. So we'll have x squared times 1, that's x squared. X squared times negative 2x to the negative 2. Again, we're going to add the exponents on x. X to the 0 is equal to 1, so this is just negative 2 or minus 2. Then we have negative 3 times positive 1, that's minus 3. And then we have negative 3 times negative 2x to the negative 2, that's positive 6x to the negative 2, or plus 6 divided by x squared. If we move x to the negative 2 to the denominator, it's going to change the sign of the exponent. So our derivative function is equal to, combining like terms, we have 2x squared terms and 3 constants. So we have 2x squared plus 1x squared. That's going to be 3x squared. And then 4 minus 2 minus 3, that's negative 1 or minus 1, plus 6 divided by x to the second. And now if we evaluate the derivative at x equals negative 2, it'll tell us the slope of the tangent line at this point. So we'll substitute negative 2 for x, and then evaluate this. So 4 times 3, that's 12, minus 1, that's 11, plus, this is going to be 6 fourths or 3 halves. Well, 3 halves is the same as 1.5. So 11 plus 1.5 is 12.5. So the slope of our line is equal to 12.5, Or if we want to put this in fraction form, 12.5 is equal to 12 1/2, which as an improper fraction would be 25/2. So now that we have the slope of our tangent line and a point on the line, we can now find the equation of our tangent line. So to find our equation, let's go ahead and use point slope form given here. And to do this, again, we're going to use the point, negative 2 comma negative 3, and a slope of 25/2. So we'll have y minus negative 3 equals 25/2 times the quantity x minus negative 2. Go ahead and simplify this. We have y plus 3 equals 25/2 times x plus 2. Let's go ahead and put this in slope-intercept form. So we'll solve this for y and distribute here. So we have y plus 3 equals, distributing here, we'll have 25/2 x. Distributing here, that's the same as 2 over 1. The 2 simplify out, so we have plus 25. And then we'll subtract 3 on both sides. So we have y equals 25/2 x plus 22. This would be the equation of our tangent line at the point negative 2, negative 3. Let's go ahead and verify this graphically. The blue graph is our original function. The point negative 2, negative 3 is here. Notice how the graph of our line is tangent at that point. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.